For the travel soul, that concept of making the journey the highlight of the experience is quite straightforward because it's literally not about reaching the destination, but the fun you will have doing it. With Immortals Fenyx Rising, we really wanted something different. We wanted a smaller world, but more dense and more vertical, and we wanted to have an exploration that was risky and uncertain. So to do that, we had an idea and we wanted to add a stamina system in the game. So why stamina? Because having that resource you have to manage as you move around encourage you to think about your navigation and how you can optimize it. So it really puts the emphasis on how you're gonna reach the destination. At some point, we took all our ideas and built like a first draft of the game in a world that we built specifically for it. And we continued to look at all the mechanics and how to make it better and better. And until the day, we reach what we have in the game today with a stamina system that really supports a smooth and fast-paced navigation and that creates a huge progression curve between what you can do at the beginning of the game and then what you can do 10 hours and 20 hours later. And on top of all of that, we also put a lot of effort in the Wings of Daedalus and the gliding that are a key part of the navigation and the stamina system. So you can glide, you can dive, you can rush through the air as you're gliding, and then you can transition back to the regular navigation, like the climbing or calling your mount. And that gives you a lot of flexibility and options as you navigate the world as long as you have stamina. So that was about the stamina. But to really make the exploration fun, we also wanted to have a game and an experience that was a platformer. So you can see that small example of a navigation challenge, how much the player is using different inputs and also is using those inputs with a different timing and different pacing. So again, you have a lot of control, you have a lot of option, and that really brings that platforming feeling to the game and the exploration. And what is cool is that on top of the exploration, that allows us to create real platforming challenge, especially in the Vault of Tartarus. So here you can see a couple of examples of the crazy thing we can do in the vault with the platforming aspect of the game. So don't worry, the one you can see here are quite hard and we have easier one in the game. But anyway, you will quickly get very good at that, as good as me, as you play the game, and you will be able to do all those crazy sequences of parkour and platforming.